welcome to a new video. In this video, we will be discussing Brooks Ghost 15. Hey! In big lines, not much has changed between the 14 and the 15, but let me cue the intro, we will jump right in. The Brooks Ghost 15 was released on December 1st, 2022. It's a neutral trainer. As mentioned, there are not many changes. The midsole has changed a bit. On the 15, it's softer and lighter, which brings us to the weight of the shoe, which is almost identical between both versions. They weigh both around 280 grams. So as you can see, not much difference there. For those who already have experience with the Ghost series, know that the shoe has a quite aggressive drop of 12 millimeters. So if you are not used to running in Brooks Ghosts, you might notice it. A 12 millimeter drop is not seen often in running shoes. But still, Brooks is keeping it alive on the Ghost 15 also. So the stack height in the back, 36 millimeters. And 24 in the front. For me, the Ghost 15 is true to size. The same was applicable for the 14. Didn't have any issues. I've got a size 46, and for me, no problems at all. You also have enough room in the toe box. If for you it wouldn't be true to size, you have a lot of possibilities, since this shoe is the best selling shoe of Brooks. So this shoe is available into sizes up to a 50 and multiple widths. Anybody can find the right size and the right width for their feet. The Ghost 15 is a bit more flexible than the 14. That's probably because, as Brooks explained, it's a bit softer, the midsole. It's a bit more flexible. If you check out the 14, it's a bit more stiff. The 14, I do agree, I found it a bit stiff when you go out for a run. I've noticed on the 14, there was not much liveliness. Don't get me wrong, it's a great shoe, but there is no energy return. For the 15, it's a bit different. It's not perfect yet. There is still a lot less energy return that you have in comparison with some other shoes, but it's improved. The wide is a bit more comfortable, but if you really want a max cushioned, comfortable wide, there are other shoes for that. The grip is also not bad. I've tested the shoe in several situations on several different type of roads. It holds up pretty good. I only had two occasions where it got a bit slippery. I have in my street cobblestones, and if it has rained a bit, it slips a bit. And also, what you need to be careful about is sewer drain covers. Slippery. For the rest, perhaps you will also need to be careful when it starts freezing outside. But that you can have with any type of shoe. That's not specific to the Ghost only. Is also not waterproof. Expect your feet to get wet. There's a lot of cushioning in the shoe, because when you slip in, you're comfortable as hell, but that comes with a downside. If water comes into the shoe, it's wet. For instance, now I've been on a run this morning, the shoe is wet and it takes a while to get dry. So if you plan on running every day with this shoe, and if you plan on running in the rain, make sure that you have another pair, a different brand, you name it, that you can have a little shoe rotation. That's something that I advise, because it could be that the shoe the day after isn't dry yet. And running in wet shoes, nobody wants that, right? The fit is perfect. Once you slide in, you're locked in. Amazing. the cushioning at the back, it's amazing. If you have a 14 and you check out the difference, it's a big difference. My God. A heel slip? Nah, ain't happening. It's really locked. The shoe itself is recommended for running at slower, easy paces. I've tried them out at a couple of speed sessions. Heel repeats, they perform actually pretty good. I was surprised. They can handle it. For small speed sessions, you can use them. Just don't forget, no energy return. That brings us to the laces. For me, the laces, practically identical between both of them. Perhaps they are just a little bit thicker. I don't know. They are comparable anyway. What I always do with the laces on a brand new pair of shoes, I only tie them once to check out how good they are. With these, didn't need to do them twice, so they are good. With the previous ones, also, just do them once and they are perfect the entire way. So, cannot complain about that. That brings us to the price of this mighty fine shoe, €150. I hear you thinking, isn't that a bit much for a daily trainer? Perhaps, but if you check out the durability of the shoe, it's a good value. Normally, you can run between 500 and 800 kilometers with a pair of running shoes. These shoes are on the higher end of that equation. If you check out the 14s, I've done about 450 kilometers with them. If you check out the sole, if you check out the sides, the wear and tear, nothing. Yeah, of course, below it's a bit less than in the beginning, but they still have their grip, they are still perfect, and that for 450 kilometers, I expect at least another 200-250 kilometers with them. These ones I've used now for 100 kilometers. They still look pretty good. They're brand new. So if you look at that, if you can run with a shoe 700, 800 kilometers for €150, some people do even more than a year with that. That's really good. That's a very durable shoe. So that's definitely a plus. The final conclusion about the Brooks Ghost series, a very decent shoe. Has it been improved in comparison with the 14? Yes. This shoe is great value, nice looking, there are different colorways, and very comfortable. Highly recommended. So yeah, some key points to take home. You're probably already home, but just write them down. If the shoe gets wet, it takes a while before it gets dry. Take that into account. The shoe has a 12 millimeter drop. If you're not used to that, that can give you some discomfort. And last but not least, I recommend putting this shoe in a shoe rotation. Don't just run with this shoe alone. Take the other one with you. Not only have this pair to run with, so that you can switch them off. It can be important also to switch between a 12 millimeter drop and an 8 millimeter drop, for example. It's something different for your legs. And also, as mentioned, because it gets wet and it's not dry perhaps the day after, then you can switch them over. You also have some people that run twice a day. Hey. And then in the evening, you cannot run with them. They are still soaking wet. You can place them under the heater, yeah, but that costs money. Huh? That's the review of Brooks Ghost 15. I hoped you liked the review. I hope you liked the bad jokes. And if you liked it, I would like to ask, click that like button, subscribe to the channel, because I'll be making more videos like this. Always a laugh. And click the little ding, 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 ding to get notified when I upload a new video. Also, now that you're here, take a look at my marathon training series, which I'm doing for the moment. Might be interesting. And If you still have additional spare time after that, here's one of my latest videos that you can check out. For now, I'm gonna wrap up. See you later. Bye.